Yes, I wish Volcano Bay was open, but look at that! And here is where we are staying for two nights. First time ever, ever being at Cabana Bay. We're gonna stay here. Yay. So here's the massive lobby, palm trees in the middle. Looks like there's a bar over there, but they're closed.
So we got into our room, it was kind of nice. And then we pulled back the curtain to look at the volcano view.
Great view, right?
And there's fingerprints all over this forehead grease.
Yeah, you probably won't be able to see it on the camera here, but
if you move the angles, you can see it.
Yeah.
And then there's plastic right there.
Yep. We did not touch that.
And then over here, there's yellowing. You can't really see it. There's yellowing on the...
There's yellow stains right there.
And then there's tape stuck right there.
Yep.
I mean, so...
We haven't touched anything except those light switches and the curtains, so...
So, for me, anyway, in normal time, this isn't bad.
Yeah.
But we're in COVID.
Yeah.
You can't clean a window.
Yeah.
You can't pull tape off of a console.
Yeah.
What else have you not cleaned? So... Sorry.
So, we did speak to a lovely front desk manager. She apologized profusely, and they're bringing new keys for us for a new room. So, we're going to go downstairs to the lobby of this building and meet them. And we'll check out the new room shortly. Here in the lobby, they do have a retro Volcano Bay poster. That's just too cool. And then they got a map of the resort. So, the lobby's here. We are all the way in this tower. After somewhat getting settled in, here's the pool area. There's the hideaway right over there. There's a lazy river over here. I think at some point we're gonna check this out. Maybe not tonight, but maybe tonight. We'll see. It's open till 9. Probably tomorrow though. We're looking for food and drinks. Here's the hideaway bar and grill. It's a pool bar. So what's cool is all our drinks are $15.50. They come in these reusable cups, and refills are $12. So I got myself the hot stuff. I'm gonna go tequila, raspberry puree, lime juice, agave nectar, and soda. Sweet. And this is the lobby area for the Bayliner Diner. Feels very like sci-fi drive-in at Hollywood Studios. I love it. So it's basically just their food court, but it smells delicious. Something Jalen pointed out here at the Bayliner Diner dining area is that they're not cleaning the tables after people get up. I can see food right on that table, just sitting there. That's kind of unfortunate. But anyway, we got the beef churrasco. So basically steak with two sides, mashed potatoes, and curry cauliflower. We got the gravy on the side with some chimichurri sauce. Used our AP discount to get $2 off, so. How is it?
Good, cauliflower's good. It's very curry.
Very curry.
Curry-ish.
Tim Curry.
It's good, I like it.
It's good. Okay, so at least 5 minutes after we sat down, it's now being cleaned, but it's probably dirty longer than that. But at least they're cleaning it, so yay. Also, the cauliflower curried cauliflower was actually pretty good. The mashed potatoes and gravy, it like wasn't outstanding, but it was still really good. Like, it was just fantastic, yeah?
The mashed potatoes were outstanding to me.
Yeah. What do you think of the steak so far?
It's delicious. It's not the best, but it's...
It's good for a food court at a theme park.
$12 for this? I'd be paying like $20 somewhere else.
And it's a lot of steak too. She just finished one piece. There's four more pieces, so it's a lot of steak.
My turn.
Yeah. Yeah, you know what? This steak is actually pretty good for a food court at a theme park. And it was $12.
Well, that was with discount.
Yeah. But it's really good. And without the chimichurri. It doesn't need it. But the chimichurri is delicious, so dip it in the chimichurri. But it's very good. Yum. One of the unique things about Cabana Bay is they got their own bowling alley, and it is open. It's only $13 per person for 45 minutes. That's not bad. bowling alley is right there, but they got their walk-up bar, and I got this. Another souvenir cup, but it's a bowling pin.
Thank you.
And it's special for Mardi Gras, hurricane, and I got the floater. Oof. Oof. There's a mermaid. Drink time. Not bad. He's funky.
I'll tell you what it is.
Orange juice. And we got pretzel bites with cheese, but they added a 50% service charge,
15.
Yes.
15% service charge. Not just to the food, which was $8.99, but to the whole bill. So if you're gonna go to the Bowlerama and order food, order the food item by itself, then order anything else you're gonna get after that.
Yeah, because it's a 15% service charge just to, for them to package the food and bring it out to us. Like, okay, whatever. These pretzels are bomb, and they're not making me thirsty. They're very good, very good. The cheese is just okay. Jalen hates it and tastes like what?
Vomit and mint.
Eh, I wouldn't say that, but it's not great. It's not bad. Eh. Pretzel's better by itself. They do have a Starbucks here. Unfortunately, they are closed. I think they're from 6 to 6 every day. And weekends, open till 10. So, that's cool. Gift shop's already closed. But not a big, big deal. And then this is the staircase here. Really cool staircase that leads up to the bowling alley and the arcade. Welcome, Mr. John Wick, to the Continental. The manager will see you. Also, there's a big issue about being able to clearly see into people's rooms. Like, there's that tower right there. And like, you zoom in, you can clearly see into people's rooms. Like, close your damn blinds, people. Come on now.
There was a naked girl up there.
There was a naked girl. Yeah, we saw a girl topless. Like, what? Well, I didn't see anything, but it looked like she was topless, but anyway.
Maybe we just shouldn't be looking.
Yeah, that's a thing. Anyway, we're going to take a lift over to Hard Rock nearby, and we're going to go check out the Hard Rock for a little bit. Look at that fountain. And we're at the Hard Rock. Universal Orlando. Never been here before. Hard Rock, Universal Orlando. Jay says it must be fake, but this is Elvis Presley.
Well, the type of material it is, it's that, and that stuff falls apart after 10, 20 years.
Yeah.
But it is super thin. It might, okay, it might be real, but...
Lady Gaga has a display here. There's some damage right there, probably from her actually wearing it. So here's the main entrance for Hard Rock. There's Elvis. There's this lobby area. This is Velvet. This is the bar that we are going to. And what's cool is Universal versus Disney is temperature checks. You get this little wristband. And that's good for the day on Universal property. If you have this wristband, you don't have to take another temperature check because you already did it. Good for parks, resorts, and City Walk. So we are here at Hard Rock at the Velvet Bar. It's very nice. And of course, Bites menu. They got some stuff that wasn't online. Yeah, that looks good. Yeah.
Steak.
Of course, their drink menu. Which, I'm getting that, of course. And we are sitting here with memorabilia from Slash. Yeah. And here is my electric Cumberbatch Mai Tai. Looks really good. Can't wait to try it. So we got the steak asada and potato chip stack, right? And you think it's like gonna be a stack, right? Like a do 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 do?
Okay,
no.
Like, who
It's like nachos. Look at this. It smells delicious. So good.
Hi, Jalen here with another unpopular opinion. The steak nachos at Hard Rock in Orlando, Florida are better than lobster nachos at Empire Lounge.
You're here first, folks. These steak nachos from Velvet Bar are better than lobster nachos. And you know what? I agree.
I mean, if Lamplight like upped their game and did their own homemade chips, which I hope they do, maybe, but even still.
Or if they were wonton chips.
Their quality has gone down over the last few years.
Yeah. Yeah. As my second round, I got the Last Resort, the tequila, vodka, mango, and spice. And actually, you know what? It's pretty tasty. Get a lot of the mango in it, not a lot of spice. It's just very well balanced, very refreshing. I like it. That's a good drink. All right, now we got the soy and braised pork belly bows with Asian slaw, cilantro, scallions, pickled red onions, and sweet soy glaze. These look delicious. The pork belly bows. These pork belly bows are so damn good. Seriously. Like, oh, it's so soft, so good. The onions, the cilantro. Oh, seriously. So good. Yum.
All right, so Tiki Andy and I are having a debate right now. So he is saying that he did not know what I was getting was nachos. So please, if you're watching this, in the comments, just want to know, it's kind of a debate, we're doing a couple right now, who was right? If you are reading behind it, the steak and asada potato chip stack, yes, the stack is misleading, but the adobe spiced beef tenderloin, manchego, cheddar and jack cheeses, green onions, and parmesan cream, what do you think that would be? Do you think it would be a stack, or do you think it spells nachos?
It would be a stack because it says stack.
I say it read as nachos. Even though it said stack, it was still... Okay, maybe they should change stack to pile. Would that make you happy?
It doesn't matter about making me happy. I was happy when it came out because it was a great surprise. Like, I was like, oh, this is awesome. It's like nachos and not a stack like I thought it would be because of the description.
And I keep saying, I thought it was nachos, and it came out exactly as I thought it would be.
Great.
By the way, he thinks it should look like this.
Because that's a stack. Speaking of stack, this is the dessert that Jalen ordered, which is...
It is the Hollywood Blonde, which is roasted pecans, vanilla bean cheesecake,
yeah, I'd be there.
Graham cracker blondie, sea salt caramel.
Oh, I am so excited for these.
You had me at the blondie, you had him at the cheesecake.
I am so excited for these.
It's
oh my
perfect.
Gosh. Let's give it a shot. Stack. It's good. It's not amazing, but it's good. You got the pecans, which are great, the cheesecake, which is great, and salted caramel, which is great. But all together, it's like, it's not amazing. It's good. I just thought it would be like a more of a pow. Like, I'm getting all the flavors. But I feel like all the flavors would have been more amazing on themselves, but... She loves it. I love it too. I thought it would be more. Well, let me try another bite. It's good. It is really good. But I feel like we had another dessert more recently that was better. I don't know. I'm trying to think of it. I don't know. I'll come back to you guys on that.
This is really good because you taste the creaminess of the cheesecake. You got the pecans. And then you have the light blondie, and it's not overpowering, it's very subtle, and it's really good. It just kind of makes you go, this is good. It's not like, in your face.
I think that's why I'm
surprised by it, because it's not in your face. It's kind of subtle. All the flavors are kind of subtle. They all work together in a subtleness, which is actually really good. It doesn't hit you too hard with sweetness. And doesn't make you go, oh, this is too sweet. I think it's a good balance of sweetness, right? So I think that's why it's probably a really good dessert.
There's the caramel on the pecan, which is that, like, really sweet. The pecans, like, drop that out.
Uh-huh.
And then the cheesecake's not too sweet, which is so good. You know what it is? It's not super sweet.
Yeah. That's what
it's more tangy.
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah.
That's good.
And $6 for 4 little pieces like that, but you get 2 bites out of each piece. That's pretty good for $6. That's really good.
That's a walnut.
So we did end up getting the other dessert, walnut maple ice cream, also $6 along with that. And just holy crap, it's so good. It's $6. It's bigger than it looks. It's so good.
We're contemplating doing this online plus Uber to get back to our hotel instead of taking a Lyft. We'll see.
All right, everyone. Thanks for watching day one here at Universal. Problems with the check-in, with the rooms, cleanliness and all that. So I don't know if it's going to get any better, but great time kind of bar hopping here and going to Velvet Bar. Tomorrow we hit up Universal for Mardi Gras, so let me know in the comments if you had any problems with room cleanliness and how bad that got. Please do like, comment, subscribe.